Joey Sturgis. Joey Sturgis is an all-in-one recording, mixing, and mastering mastermind who works out of his own studio, The Foundation, in quiet little Connersville, Indiana. He is my personal favorite engineer because his records sound amazing. Emphasis on the amazing. Let's take a look back at the history of the Sturge. Joey Sturgis started recording in 2004 in his friend's garage when he was 19. He needed a way to record a demo of his own band at the time, so he taught himself the basics of recording. The following year, Sturgis recorded a demo for some no-name band called The Devil Wears Prada. This demo got the band signed to Rise Records and drew the label's attention to Sturgis. The band came back to Sturgis for their first full-length album, which in turn launched both his career as an engineer and The Devil Wears Prada's career as a nationally touring band. Craig Erickson, the owner of Rise Records, became Joey's manager and quickly made Sturgis his go-to guy. Since 2006, Sturgis has 23 albums under his belt through Rise Records alone, although he does work with other labels and unsigned artists. Between 2007 and 2008, Sturgis had 21 albums that he worked on released, including The Devil Wears Prada's second full-length, Plagues. A few other examples of his work from this time period include Sea of Treachery's debut album, At Daggers Drawn, as well as Attack Attack's debut album, Someday Came Suddenly, which launched them into the limelight. I know a call. 2009, which I like to call the Year of the Sturgis, because this is the first year he started injecting his albums with steroids. These next four albums you'll hear are still, to this day, four of my personal favorite albums, as well as four of the best-sounding albums I've ever heard. Let's all take a moment to bask in their glory. Yes, I will.
Oh, the bullet's gone. I take this pain, I slit your throat.
This next example shows a comparison between a demo and a final version of the song Architect by Miss Mayotte. The demo was not recorded with Joey Sturgis, but the final album version was recorded with Joey Sturgis. See if you can notice a difference.
. 2010
was a continuation of the pure awesomeness that was 2009, including Attack Attack's second album and a zombie-themed concept EP courtesy of The Devil Wears Prada. In total, Sturgis worked on 23 albums during these 2 years. 2011 featured a few more of my favorite albums, including The Color Morale's second album, My Devil in Your Eyes, which Joey even lent some guest vocals to. This year also saw the release of Joey's most commercially successful album to date, Asking Alexandria's Reckless and Relentless, which reached number 9 on the Billboard 200. With each of his releases, I think to myself, wow, this couldn't possibly get any better. And then it does. Earlier this year, Icy Stars released their third album, Digital Renegade, which I can only describe as sounding un-f***ing real. All thanks to Joey Sturgis. Sturgis is scheduled to work with 12 more artists by the end of the year, which will bring his grand total of albums he has worked on to a menacing 78 at the age of only 27. To me, Joey Sturgis is not just an engineer, but is instead a dark wizard of the craft who conjures up spells that transform mere music into something much more.